Good afternoon, it's Carolyn here from Waiheke Island down under in New Zealand. The Kohekohe is one of our beautiful subtropical looking native trees. In this video I'll be sharing how to identify the tree just by using the leaves, because the trunk is hard to identify. It's hard to tell which is the Kohekohe just looking at the trunk, and the flowers are hardly ever there, so we're going to just go with the leaves. There's three things about the leaves that are going to help us identify it. One, it's got lush leaves. Two, it's got compound pinnate leaves. Don't worry, I'll explain what that is and I'll make it easy. Three, it's got big leaves. Let's go and find one. Here's a baby Kohekohe, and this is a good place to start. So what was the first thing that I said? I said they have quite a lush looking leaf, and you can see that's a pretty lush looking leaf, isn't it? It's nice and glossy green. It's about the thickness of a lemon leaf, so a citrus leaf, but it is beautiful and lush. The second thing I mentioned was it's got a compound pinnate leaf, so I'll explain what that is and I'll make that easy for you. So the entire leaf is this whole piece here. So see how there's one, two, three on this side, three on that side, and one on the end. So there's seven. Those are leaflets. And the entire whole of that makes up one leaf. I know that might sound a bit confusing, but let's just think of it this way. You can see the little baby trunk coming up here. And then there's a small swell, and out the side comes this, what I call a little driveway. And the leaf decides to do some subdivision, and it creates these other little driveways out to these things called leaflets. So those are technically leaflets. And then at the end, it's a cul-de-sac here, so they've put another little drive and they've put one on the end as well. So that's called a compound leaf and a compound pinnate leaf. And here's a bigger one, same sort of thing. So this whole thing is a leaf. This is a leaf. It's quite big, isn't it? It's not seven little leaves, it's one big leaf. And that brings me to the next point, that it's a big leaf. So if I put my arm up on this, put my elbow down at the bottom, it goes well up above my hand. I put it next to my boot so you can see the size of it. It's pretty big. It's longer than from my elbow to the tip of my hands, isn't it? So let's just go over those again. It's lush. It looks lush. You can see this is lush. Got a subtropical look. It's got a compound pinnate leaf. So I know that is the hardest piece to understand. Just imagine where it joins onto the trunk. It's got a little road coming out here. It's subdivided into properties, and it's got leaflets on each one. And at the end of the cul-de-sac, it's got another leaflet on it as well. And that whole thing is a compound. So it's a group of parts, a group of things together, and it makes one leaf. So it's got this pinnate, and pinnate refers to how it sits side by side like that and goes up that one straight road. Let's go and have a look around and see what else is here and see if there's something that we might confuse it with. So just a few feet away is another plant that has lush leaves, doesn't it? It does have lush leaves. But are they pinnate compound leaves? No, they're not. They're just on their own, aren't they? They're coming off the side just on their own, coming straight off the side of the trunk on their own. And they're not big, are they? I tell you what, they're super lush though, real lush, but they're not big and they're not compound pinnate leaves. So you know that is not the Kohekohe. Let's go and have a look around. Here's another one of those right by it. You know it's not because it doesn't have the compound leaf. Straight off, you know that. What about over here? So here's one that looks kind of lush, isn't it? It's not as lush though. And look at its leaf, it's something different, isn't it? So this is a palmate compound leaf. So it comes out shaped like a palm. So it's not in that road, is it? It doesn't have that long straight road. It's got a circle in the center and they all come out from it. Here's a tiny little baby one. So this is what they look like when they're baby. So it's got a lime green color to it, so it hasn't deepened up like this one here, but it has got that compound pinnate leaf with the one on the end already, and obviously they're not very big, but they will get big. What about this one here? This is super lush. It's quite a bit darker. It's in the dark, so they tend to get darker when they're not exposed to the light as much. It's super lush. Yes, it's a compound pinnate. If we go to the top here, we can see that road down, and then it's got this big one here at the end in the cul-de-sac. So it's got, let's have a look, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 leaves. So it's got an odd number, which is what we are looking for. What about down here? This one looks kind of lush too. It's got a compound pinnate leaf, but if we have a look at the end, it's missing that odd one. So it's just got even numbers. And if we look even a bit closer, we'll find that it's a vine. It's climbing around here. It's not even a tree. So that's something to be careful of, is that you pay attention to whether you've got a tree or a vine. One of the natives that has the closest leaf to the kohekohe, in my opinion, is a Techomanthe speciosa, but that is only found in one place, in fact one plant, and that's on the Three Kings. So unless you're on the Three Kings, it's most likely that you found a kohekohe. Another native plant that looks similar to the kohekohe is the TITOKI. So the TITOKI is lush. It has a compound pinnate leaf. It also has that one at the end in the cul-de-sac, but it's nowhere near as big as the kohekohe. This kohekohe is nearly as long as my arm, this one. It's huge. Looking up into the canopy, I can see a lot of big, lush pinnate leaves up there. A non-native plant that would look a bit like that is the walnut. So the walnut tree has that big compound pinnate leaf, and it does have that one on the end in the cul-de-sac. But the difference is that it's not as lush as this, and also you wouldn't expect to find it here. Another thing about the walnut is that it's deciduous, so it would lose its leaves in the winter, unlike our native kohekohe. Let's just recap. So we're looking for leaves that are lush. We're looking for leaves that are compound pinnate, and we're looking for leaves that are big, real big. So if you've got those three things, then most likely you've got the beautiful New Zealand kohekohe. See you next time.